Hey there, I've got some interesting news to share with you. I've been doing the package deliveries for UberEats. You know what those are? Yeah, where you go to the grocery store and you pick up the groceries and the workers have already done the work for you. Well, guess what? The workers put the customer's receipt in the bag with you and you have full access to it so you can check out their order. And of course it has all their personal information on there. So I'm gonna redact much of that from this video. But I did find it interesting because right in there, it shows you how much they tipped and how much the fee was if there was a delivery fee. I've done maybe 5 or 6 of these orders, and it was only at one store that the one time they didn't put the receipt in. So let's take a look. This is from November. I got paid $15.09 and the base pay was $11.09. The total distance was 3.8 miles. And it was a driver tip of $4. What I do find fascinating, if you see right here, the delivery fee to the customer was $9.95. Why would the customer pay a fee to deliver? I don't know. Let's look at a couple more orders. And these are from December. I made a total of $24.72. Base pay was $17.72. And the tip combined was $7. Total distance was 5.8 miles. So that's really good, right? $25 for almost 6 miles. I would take those orders all day. Digging into the receipt, the customer was charged $3.95 because it says minimum order fee under $30. They charged $3.95. And then it's something here on this other customer, their total was $42. And I see here, they didn't have a delivery fee at all. So I wonder what that's all about. Either way, the thing that I find interesting for us delivery drivers, who's paying the bill? Do some customers pay a delivery fee and some don't? Okay, obviously UberEats has to make money, so they must have a deal with the store. So if the customer's not paying, then the store must be paying UberEats. Ultimately, if UberEats wants us to do the delivery, then they've got to be paying us, right? So that's where the base pay comes in. And I did notice on the one, it said a trip supplement. I don't know. The last couple that I've done recently, it's been a low base pay, like $5. And then the customer would tip on top of that, but it was really short distance and I was nearby. Even at that low base pay and tip, I would still do the order. It was easy because you don't have to go in and do the shopping. The workers at the store already do that for you. So it's easy, you just go in, show them the name, grab the bags, and go deliver them. Today I had a great order. The customer ended up tipping me $20. Yeah, so I made $25.07 and it was less than a mile delivery. And the offer came in at $13.07. And sure enough, there was the hidden tip. And I saw it right away because when they gave me the receipt for the customer, I could see in there that the customer had tipped me $20. And of course, once I finished the delivery, then it popped up in the app and they acted like it was some added on bonus from the customer. But in reality, the customer had tipped well beforehand. Because think about it, they need time to pull the order, print the paperwork, and then summon the independent contractor like you to come pick it up and deliver it. Early on with rideshare, I think the investors were paying Uber and Lyft drivers to drive as they were building their business. In time, the food delivery industry has matured. There's many companies out there, but someone has to pay. Is it the investors? Is it the restaurants? Is it the customer? Or is it everybody? So I do find that interesting, and I'm sure that you do as well if you think about it. Because from a job security perspective, we want to be able to make money to earn a good living. And that's whether you're doing it part-time or full-time. So where our pay comes from ultimately does matter. Now, I hear you. Short-term, yeah, I don't care either. I'm out to make money and whatever order comes up and it is suitable for me and meets my criteria of dollars per mile or dollars per hour, then I'm gonna take it. And short term, yeah, it doesn't really matter. For everybody out there, have you already noticed the receipts going out with your grocery package deliveries for UberEats? Please share in the details below. What have you found on there? Who's paying the bill? Do you see a variety of limits on the customer? You know, if the order is higher than a certain amount, it's free? Or do some get charged different rates? What do you think about it? And please, do take those package deliveries from UberEats. They pay really well, and it's very easy. It's kind of like, you know, going to the restaurant to get the food. The workers have already done it for you, and you just deliver it to the customer. Ha! Making money is so important, and I know that you know that too, right? So up next, please enjoy this video that I made about some tips on how to be profitable in 2022. And guess what? Yeah, it does apply to next year as well. All right, everybody, I'll see you in the comments below on this video, and I'll catch up with you on that video too. Oh, and my name is Russ. Don't forget to like the channel and video, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye.